Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. We look at the previous time frame, the SSGI graph with earthquakes magnitude 5.5 and larger, and we see right at the beginning around the 10th, obvious cluster of stronger earthquakes peaking actually magnitude 6.8, and that was in the Cuba region. And you may recall in the previous update that I mentioned the Caribbean plate. The fluctuation was actually a little bit to the west near Puerto Rico, but we did have the 6.8 at Cuba, near Cuba. And there was clustered there strong earthquakes around the 10th with the critical geometry that I discussed in the previous update. You may want to look that up. Then we didn't have really much, no higher 5 magnitude earthquakes in the entire time frame, but we did have 6.6 and 5.5 minimal clustering on the 15th following the critical geometry on the 14th. And that was close to full moon, by the way, and also a 6.1 southeast of the Ryukyu Islands near Japan on the 17th. And that was with the lunar conjunction with Jupiter that I also discussed in the previous update, because it can result in a larger earthquake later today. I mentioned the 19th. That's about 2 days, 2.5 days from the moment of that lunar conjunction with Jupiter on the 17th, which brings us to the next time frame. And we see right at the beginning critical planetary geometry, and we actually have 5 planetary conjunctions coming up from the 18th to the 22nd. The first was yesterday morning with Earth between Mercury and Jupiter. And let's have a look at the solar system, how that actually looks like. Mercury, Earth, Jupiter yesterday morning, and that is followed by Sun, Mercury, Venus this morning. And Sun, Mercury, Venus usually results in a stronger earthquake, usually borderline 6, low 6 magnitude within about 2 days. And so that would be around the 21st, 22nd. Then Sun, Mercury, Saturn, a critical planetary conjunction on the 20th, early in the morning of the 20th. And that these 3 planetary conjunctions will be followed by a lunar conjunction with Mars on the 20th. And then we end up around the 22nd again for a possible obvious seismic response. And then finally, Sun, Venus, Saturn on the 22nd. And 5 hours later only, followed by Sun, Mercury, Neptune. So we have 2 planetary conjunctions on the 22nd. A near exact convergence there with Sun, Venus, Saturn and Sun, Mercury, Neptune. The Sun is involved in both planetary conjunctions. And the last time a large earthquake, a really large earthquake occurred, magnitude 7.8, was in February 2023 in Turkey. And that followed also on a convergence of 2 planetary conjunctions. The difference is that at that time it happened at full moon as well. Here we have 2 planetary conjunctions, again with Venus and Mercury. It's always critical, and as a result, there can be a larger earthquake about two and a half days later, but there is something else going on here. So let's have a look at the SGI graph again. We have 2 lunar conjunctions, also with Saturn and Neptune. They were both involved in the planetary conjunctions on the 22nd, and we have Moon, Earth, Saturn late on the 23rd, and Moon, Earth, Neptune early on the 25th. And there can be a large earthquake following those lunar conjunctions, and then we would end up around the 26th. It could be earlier, but we take that time frame into account, about 2.5 days. That's the most critical time following lunar conjunctions, if they follow on planetary conjunctions like we had on or going to have on the 22nd. That's the planetary and lunar geometry that we're going to have in the next time frame. Again, 5 planetary conjunctions from the 18th to the 22nd. That is 1 planetary conjunction on average every day. That is a lot, well above average. And I expect an obvious seismic response, clustering of stronger earthquakes, higher 5 magnitude into the 6 magnitude range. And there could be 1 or 2 larger earthquakes as well. The clustering may occur actually today, tomorrow already with the critical planetary geometry. We already had 5.6 this morning, the latest updates near Tonga, and that could be the start of a clustering of stronger earthquakes. But keep in mind the 2 planetary conjunctions on the 22nd. That is a really critical convergence there, followed by 2 lunar conjunctions also involving the same outer planets. If we look at the atmospheric fluctuations, the latest fluctuations, they were from yesterday. They mark the North Pacific, and the North Pacific has been marked by atmospheric fluctuations since the 12th. There could be a seismic response there, and don't underestimate that. It is a remote area. Nobody lives there. That's what we could think, but it is a subduction zone, and history tells us that it can generate large earthquakes and also large tsunamis, which will affect, if that happens, if it were to happen, the entire Pacific Basin, especially Hawaii. So don't underestimate those subduction zones around the Pacific. But in particular, the North Pacific, it has been a while since there has been a megafrost earthquake there. And if you look at the antipode, more or less, that marks the region in the Middle East around Iraq. Iran, I think, is critical, and possibly eastern Turkey, where we've seen some seismic increase as well. So these are the latest updates. Check out the website and also our social media. We're probably going to pick up atmospheric fluctuations that may indicate areas where larger earthquakes can occur. This is the update so far. Stay safe. Until next time.